Hi students, today we are discussing about some questions in linear programming problem. Here is a question.
Minimize result r is equal to minus of p x plus 21. Subject to the constraints 2x minus y greater than or equal to minus 5, 3x plus y greater than or equal to 3, 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 12, and two non-zero constraints, x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0, isn't it? Now we are going to draw the graph of this function. So, first inequality can be written as 2x minus y is equal to minus 5. When x is equal to 0, minus y is equal to minus 5, therefore y is equal to 5. And when y is equal to 0, 2x is equal to minus 5 and x is equal to minus 5 by 2. The next inequality, 3x plus y is equal to 3. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3 and y is equal to 0, 3x is equal to 3, so x is equal to 1. And the third inequality is 2x minus 3y, that is equal to 12. To draw the graph of this inequality, convert it into an inequality. So 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. When x is equal to 0, minus 3y is equal to 12, so y is equal to minus 4. And when y is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 12, so x is equal to 6. Using this data, we draw the graph of this function. And now, find the feasible region. The first inequality is 2x minus y greater than or equal to minus 5. Put x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, so LHS becomes 0 greater than or equal to minus 5, which is true. 0 is greater than minus 5. So, in this case, we draw the graph. The region is like this. Object is included here. The second inequality is 3x plus y greater than or equal to 3. Here we put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. So, 0 greater than or equal to 3. In the second inequality, if you put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, here 0 is greater than or equal to 3. This is a false statement. So, we origin is not recorded, so we take this half plane, the opposite half plane of origin, and the last inequality 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 12, so x is equal to 0 is equal to 0, 0 less than or equal to 12, which is true. In this case, we draw the graph like this. Okay. Now we have two non-zero constraints, so y is equal to 0 is x axis and x is equal to 0 is the y axis. Here, the feasible region is unbounded. All these graphs, this graph comes this side, this graph upper side, and this graph right side. So, and in the first quadrant, these two non-zero constraints. So, the feasible region is unbounded here. Feasible region is unbounded here. So, the corner points are here A, 0, 5. B 0 A 0 5 B 0 3 C 1 0 and D 6 0, and these are the corner points. Using corner points, we can find the value of this angle. Here A 0 5, not 6, 5. Here that is 100, this angle is 100. B 0 3 is a D 60, C 1 0 is a D minus 50, and D 6 0 is a D minus 50 into 6 minus 10 under plus 0 minus 10 under plus 10. Here the minimum value of result is minus 300. If result is equal to minus 300 is the minimum value of result. We have to draw one more graph, that is minus 50x plus 20y is equal to this minus 300. Here we can eliminate 0, so, and multiply the power by negative 1. So we get 5x minus 2y is equal to 30. Now when x is equal to 0, minus 2y is equal to 30, y is equal to minus 15, and when y is equal to 0, 5x is equal to 30, so x is equal to 6. Now we draw one more graph, and this graph go through like this, and some points on the graph passes through the feasible region. Since the resulting open half plane has points in common with the feasible region, so Z has no minimum value, isn't it? If Z has minimum value, then the resulting open half plane has no point in common with the feasible region. Here, certain points, some points on this graph are lying in the feasible region, so there is no minimum value for Z, isn't it? In the second question, maximize Z is equal to 5x plus 5y subject to the constraints. 3x plus 5y less than or equal to 15, 5x plus 2y less than or is equal to 10, and x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0, isn't it? Here, 3x plus 5y is equal to 15. When x0, y3 and y0, x5. Second graph is 5x plus 2y is equal to 10. Here, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 5, and then y is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. Here, the graph of one, two, three, four, five. Two, three, four, five. In the first graph, x is 5 and y is 3. X 5 and y 3. Here 3x plus 5y is equal to 15. Next graph is when x is equal to 2, y is equal to 5. Join these two. Here 5x plus 2y is equal to 10. Now the feasible region, first graph is feasible region. 5x plus 5y less than or equal to 15. So 0 less than or equal to 15, 2. So we say here 0 is included, origin is included here, and 5x plus 2y less than or equal to 10. Here also 0 less than or equal to 10, which is also true. So this graph, the shaded region is here. So first graph is like this, second graph is like this. So the feasible region is, this is the feasible region, isn't it? And the common points are 0, 0. Here A, 2, 0. And here B, C, 0, 3. To find B, solving these two equations, 3x plus 5y is equal to 15, and 5x plus 2y is equal to 10. Now, multiplying equation 1 and 2.
equation 1 by 2 minus equation 2 by 5. So 6x plus 21 is equal to 30, and 25x plus 21, final term is 50. So subtracting, changing the signs, and here 19x is equal to minus 20 minus 19x. Therefore, x is equal to 20 by 19 in 1. 3 into 20 by 19 plus 5y is equal to 50. Here we can eliminate 5 on both sides. So 3 into 4 by 19 plus y is equal to 3. Therefore, y is equal to 3 minus 12 by 19. That is 19 into 3, 57 minus 12 divided by 19. Therefore, y is equal to 45 divided by 19. Therefore, the corner points are the corner points O 0 0, A 2 0, B is 20 by 19, 45 by 19. And C is 0, 3. Now we can find the maximum value inside point, and Z is equal to 5x plus 3y. Here first point O 0, 0. Z is equal to 5 into 0 plus 3 into 0, that is 0. Second point is 2, 0. Here Z is equal to 5 into 2 plus 3 into 0. So we get 10. B is 20 by 19, 45 by 19. So we get Z is equal to 5 into 20 by 19 plus 3 into 45 by 19. So we get 100 plus 135 divided by 19. So 235 by 19. And the last point C. C is 0, 3. Therefore, Z is equal to 5 into 0 plus 3 into 3, that is 9. Here the maximum value of Z is 235 by 19. Therefore, Z max is equal to 235 by 19 at B, isn't it? Here the feasible region is bounded. So we can easily find the maximum or minimum value of Z. If the feasible region is unbounded, then we have to find the graph of this function again with the minimum or maximum value, and no point on the graph lies in the feasible region, then that will be the minimum or maximum value. If any point lies in the feasible region, then the function has no maximum or minimum value, isn't it?